Hello viewers, I'm Paras Kumar and in this video I'll try to summarize my project which I did during the summer. So let's get started. And here is my project titled CAD Data Extraction for CFD Simulations. And now, before we dive into the details of the project, it is important to analyze these two terms, CAD and CFD.
CAD or Computer Aided Design is the technical discipline involving application of computers or the so-called supercomputers to the design of products ranging from your cell phone to the wings of an aircraft. This is much more viable, not only economically, but also in terms of time and effort when compared to the traditional approach of testing with physical prototypes. The numerical technique used for solving problems involving solid materials, such as the one shown above, is called the finite element method. Another category of problems is the one which involves flow of fluids such as air, water, or even blood for that matter, around some solid object such as an airplane, a ship, or our blood vessels. Now that we know what CAD and CFD actually mean, let's try to understand how they are connected to each other. The CAD model, hereafter referred to as CAD data or simply CAD, contains the geometric details of the product and is created using a CAD modeling software such as SolidWorks or OpenCascade. The CAD data serves as the starting point for various computer-based design validation techniques or the so-called simulation techniques, including FEA and CFD. This self-explanatory diagram describes the different steps involved in a CFD analysis. As described in this diagram, CAD model is fed as input to the preprocessor, which transforms the problem into an equation system which is then solved to get the results. This seems to be a perfect process chain, but there's a problem. The CAD data as supplied by the designer almost invariably contains small details unnecessary for simulation. These include small parts such as nuts, bolts, screws, and intricate feature details like holes, fillets, chamfers. Using this data directly for numerical simulation could lead to a much more complex or even incorrect numerical model. And so this made me think CAD is bad. Okay, so I'm a good guy and I decided to fix this bad CAD. Geometric cleanup or defeaturing refers to the removal of these unwanted intricate details and is one of the trickiest subtasks in the process chain. If handled manually, this could be quite cumbersome and time-consuming. Thus, I tried to develop a utility based on the programming language Python to automate the defeaturing process. For dealing with geometry, Python OCC, that is a Python-based implementation of the OpenCascade library, is employed. And thus, we have the modified CAD CFD process chain. The utility in its present state provides the user with the following functionalities: removal of parts with volume below a specified threshold, removal of holes with radii less than a specified value, removal of fillets with radii less than a specified value. Out of these, fillets are the most complicated ones to deal with, so let's check them out first. Fillet is a rounding of the sharp edges of a component. For the purpose of defeaturing, a classification based on the rounding done at the end of the edge forming the fillet has been employed. The classes currently handled by this utility include isolated edge fillet, single connected edge fillet, double connected edge fillet. As a demonstration of how defeaturing is done within the utility, we consider the example of a box containing four isolated edge fillets. The defeaturing process begins by identification of the fillet face and the neighboring faces. The next step is the determination of the axial line by the intersection of the two axial faces. Next, the corner points are determined by the intersection of the axial line with the two radial faces. These corner points form the corner edge, which should be there in the defeatured model. Next, the extended faces are created using the corner edge and the neighboring edges. And finally, the shell obtained from the extended faces is used to create the defeatured solid. The algorithm has been designed such that it can be applied iteratively to other fillets present in the model, and thus we have the model without fillets. Now that we have seen how fillets are defeatured, let's have a look at the defeaturing of a model containing other target features in addition to fillets. As example, we consider the model of a wind barrier, which is used to alter the flow pattern so as to reduce the crosswind forces acting on the vehicles going on a highway. And now, let the show begin. Thus, we have the defeatured model of the wind barrier ready for CFT analysis. Hope you enjoyed the video. Goodbye.